Okay, Thomas, it is day plus one, which is the first day after your treatment. Up until then, all the days were negative days. And your transplant day, which was yesterday, was day zero. So now we want to just ask you a little bit about how did the process go? Did you have any side effects or anything?
No, thank God for that. No side effects, no serious side effects. I thank God for that. They gave me the Benadryl and they monitored me. I went to sleep, took a nice good nap, and I was groggy once everything was done. When I woke up, everybody was gone. Well, not everybody, my lovely wife, but she was here. But thank God for her. And she, update me on everything. I would suggest anybody going through this to have a loved one with you, because you in and out, and days have passed by. You just, it'd be best to have someone to keep you alert for this
Okay.
process.
So, can you tell us a little bit about what you know about your donor?
Well, I know they 21 years old. And I think it's a female donor, and they just so happen to be a 6 out of 8 for me. So,
And a 6 out of 8, that's a mismatch donor, right?
yes.
But because of the new medications and research that they've done, they were able to find that a person that's even 6 out of 8 can now be a donor and have successful transplant, right?
Yes. Praise
Okay.
Jesus for that.
Praise Jesus. Thank God for the donor. So tell me a little bit about how you're feeling today, day plus one, first day to your first 100 days. How are you feeling about how you feeling, how your body's feeling?
Well, I got slight chills, but I was still able to get up, walk around, crack true joke with the staff. They're down to earth. And I was in motion. Like I said, this journey, definitely need Jesus. You definitely would I would recommend have a partner that you could trust. Because anyone going through the journey by themselves, God help you and bless you, because it's a journey. But I'm making it through. Still making it through. Thank God.
Amen, amen, amen. So, is there anything that you would like to say, something that you weren't expecting that happened, or anything that you would like to let somebody know who might be getting ready to go to through this process that might be curious?
Well, my thing is this. For this procedure, it is something that is very beneficial for people who may have immune deficiency. And this, so far, what I'm experiencing is a help, a big help. And I've been having an old condition. I ain't claiming it no more.
You
But
had.
I had an old condition called Bruton's, and that will be wiped away.
Also the T cell lymphoma.
And a T cell lymphoma as well. And then on top of it, I end up getting COVID.
But you do
So
not
I have it.
have that right
I
now.
don't have that right now. No,
So we,
I
yeah.
don't have that. I don't have none of those right now. All I know is it's a rejuvenation process.
Amen.
And it's good to know that you have someone on your side, spiritually and physically, that can encourage you through the journey. And it's good to have a mindset, a positive mindset, as they put it. I say a mindset also on God.
Yes.
I mean, God, the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the Prince of Peace, Lord Jesus Christ. Have your mind set on Him, because He said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in Him." So
Yeah.
that's the thing we got to keep in mind too. Don't put God out of nothing. Put Him in it, because He want to be part of everything we get into. because when he get lifted up, he drawing.
Amen. So
that's the good thing about knowing this journey I'm walking with my wife. We're not walking alone. So all I can say is to those who do see the video, may God bless you.
Yeah.
And I'm continuing on because he hasn't let me down yet, and I appreciate him for that.
Amen. Thank you. All right. So day one, we'll try to come back every day as long as he feels up to it until our last day here at the hospital. Right? Okay. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.